Today we're going to talk about the concepts of simple versus compound interest. Compound interest is one of the foundational concepts in all of finance and investments. And essentially, the difference between simple versus compound interest is whether or not interest earned is reinvested or capitalized onto the original amount. Simple interest is not added or reinvested into the original principal amount. So the amount of interest earned is the same throughout the life of investment, effectively yielding a straight line return or yield. Compound interest, on the other hand, is reinvested and added to or capitalized on the original principal amount, therefore increasing the value of the investment so that future interest earnings are earned both on the original principal and on interest. In other words, we earn interest on interest. Albert Einstein called compound interest the eighth wonder of the world because over time, compound interest creates exponentially higher returns. Let's look at an example. Imagine we have a $1,000 investment that earns 12% each year for 3 years. I'll show you the comparison between a simple interest investment at 12% versus a compound interest at 12%. In the case of simple interest, we would earn on our $1,000 investment $120 each year. So over the 3 year life of the investment, we would yield $360 on our original $1,000. Now, conversely, in compound interest, each time we earned interest, it's added to the original principal. So future interest payments are based on the sum of both. Let me show you how that works. In the case of compound interest, where we're still earning interest just once per year, in the first year we would make $120 on our original $1,000. But in the second year, we would actually make interest on $1,120, therefore yielding an interest payment of $134. And then in the third year, we would earn interest of $151. So as you can see, with compound interest, we earn an extra $45 worth of interest over the life of the 3 year investment. But there's another concept that goes a little bit deeper with compound interest, which is the compound interval. And compound interval states how many times per year we get paid interest on both the principal and our previous interest. In the case of annual compounding, it means we get one interest payment per year. The entire 12% is paid out once per year. In the case of monthly compounding, as is in the case with almost all real estate, finance, and investments, that 12% is divided up into 12 months. So a 12% nominal return, which is the named rate, would be paid at 1% per month. The effect of monthly compounding versus annual compounding is that we earn 1/12 of our interest in the first month for the year. So the next 11 months, we are earning interest on that interest. And then each month, we get what is a greater compounding effect because we are earning interest on our interest more frequently and earlier. Let me show the effect of monthly compounding. In the case of monthly compounding, we would earn 1% interest each month throughout the life of the investment. The effect of that would be that we would earn $127 in the first year, $143 in the second year, and $161 in the third year, for a total of $431 worth of interest earned. And then once again, that's because we're earning interest every month, so we're earning interest on our interest earlier and more often. Now let's see what happens if we had daily compounding. If we had daily compounding on this investment, we would be earning 1/365th of 12% interest each day. The effect of that would be a few cents more in the first year, an extra dollar compared to monthly compounding in the second year, and almost a couple bucks in the third year. I intentionally rounded these numbers to not have to mess with the pennies. But as you can see, the cumulative effect of that, the daily compounding, is even a couple more dollars worth of interest earned because of the more frequent compounding. The effect of this increase in the frequency of compounding intervals gives us what's known as the effective annual rate or effective annual yield. And as we can see, In the case of annual compounding, where we get paid interest once per year, our annual yield is the same as the nominal rate. It's 12%. But when we're earning extra interest, like say each month, more often, it actually increases our yield because we're getting more interest on our interest throughout the year. So the effective annual rate of 12% with a monthly compounding is actually 12.6. And of course, the effective rate for daily compounding is 12.75. Effective annual rate is also known as what's called annual percentage yield. The nominal rate, the stated rate or named rate, which is 12% in this case, is the APR or the annual percentage rate. The annual percentage yield refers to the effective annual rate that is based on the number of compounding intervals. Typically in real estate, almost everything we do is monthly compounding, but certain types of loans, some student loans out there use daily compounding or credit cards. And sometimes that's why you will see a stated difference between the annual percentage rate, which is the nominal rate, and the annual percentage yield, which is the effective rate. This might seem confusing at first, but don't worry, we're going to get into this a lot because everything we do in real estate, finance, investments is all based on the concept of compounding interest and calculating effective yields. Understanding these concepts will make you better able to analyze investments and create accurate projections going forward.